First of all, thank you for voting for the photography class. As we haven't done any practical class yet, this video you are going to see some practicals covering the compositions like the rules of taking photographs which I have explained in the previous class. If this is your first class, stop watching this video here and do watch the previous classes and open this video again, or you won't understand some terminologies like shutter, ISO and aperture. And as we don't have too many resources to shoot this video because of work from home, so kindly ignore the mistakes in the video. In this class, you're going to see low shutter photos, center composition photos, and how to take photos in low light without using flash. Let's begin the video.
Hello guys, today we are doing the practical class. So we are in MG Road. Actually, photography we have to take during the sunrise or during the sunset, like preferably like 6 to 8:30 in the morning and 3:30 to 6 o'clock in the evening. But I choose now it's 11:50. Why I choose this time? Because usually when you go for a trip, you go to a point in this kind of time. So let's see how photographs we can take like jam great. So guys, I found this place. It is Church Street. So here vehicles are not allowed. So, and this road, if you can see, it's a center line. So left and right, you can see a path going to the infinity. So if we just find a place where we can get just little a shadow, then nice photo will come. Let's do it. So guys, I'm having 5D Mark II body and any lens if you can take, but as of now I'm having a good lens. I'm using that. This is f/2.8 70 200 mm. When you're connecting to Canon stuff, like this red dot, you have to see. In Nikon, I guess it is white. It's done. I'll ask the model to go to the center point and I'll ask her to give a pose and let's take a rotation shot. Like I'll ask the model to rotate and let's take a shutter shot, like fast shutter, where we can capture every moment. So guys, as you can see, it's heavy bright, but I can also decrease this. I can bring it, but I don't want that. I just want a more shutter. Brightness is okay for me and I want only the model, so I'm using the best 2.8 here. If you don't have f/2.8 lens, you can use f/4. This you can use, but as I'm having 2.8 option, I'm using till 2.8. so I'm keeping good shutter so that every click can be captured. In general, people who are not having proper command, they can go for multiple shots, like high speed continuous. If we just click and hold, then automatically lot of photos it will take. So, but in real time, you have to do it with single. Okay, let's take the model photo. Yeah, I can see her. Read it. So just now I have connected f/4 lens. Now we are taking another pose. Let's see the configuration again. Little shadow zone. I just made it f/4 or f/4.5. Everything will be fine. So if you feel it is more brighter, you can increase or decrease the shutter. If you want, if you are keeping more ISO, more brightness it will come. Just keep little less ISO. I'm fine with this f/4 and a shutter 1250 and 1250 ISO, but shutter this much is not required. I'll just change the ISO. Yeah, this is fine for me. And the model is right away there. Pose.
So as we can see a straight line over here.
So we can randomly use, no need of using only in the center. See, I have asked her to sit in one of the side. So I'll use the left side green path and right side the path. So let's take a photo. Look up, look up, look up. Hand. Here we just found a nice graphic painting, graffiti. Let's try to take a photo with this place and let's try again. Little left, my left. Yeah. Little right. Okay, ready. Till now you have seen fast shutter photos. Now we are at Formangala Forum Mall. So now we are going to show you how to take low light photos or low shutter photos also. Let's see for a place. Before showing you the low shutter photos, even for taking a low light photo also, we have to keep low shutter. Low, what is low? Completely low shutter photos. Basically, when we are taking less than 1 second, like this number, if it is one or below, we usually call it as low shutter photos. Basically, when we are taking very between 1 to 100, we call it as low light photos. When we have very dark environment, then we are going to use numbers like 30, 60, like that, and 10 also you can go for. As of now, we'll take 30 and f1.8 lens. So this lens, we call it as prime lens, and it is having a fixed focal length of 50 mm, and it is having f1.8. If you haven't gone through the classes before, like I'll be giving the links, like what is aperture and what is shutter speed. So as you all can see, the place is little shady and dark. Now if you take from your mobile, it will not come so great. So even if you are taking with your mobile or with your DSLR, these are the settings. The shutter speed should be very low, it should be less than 100. So as of now, I'm taking 30 and 1.8 and 2 and ISO 250, which is very low. Usually ISO, we'll use it when we are having less brightness, like we'll increase it whenever we want more brightness. Now also we can do that, let's do with 30 shutter and let's finish it up. So we have chosen this place in Forum Mall where we are seeing some displays and some light is there. So I want to utilize that light. So I have asked her to stand there so that some kind of light also will be there additional with this shutter speed. So basically, when you are using prime lens, this lens is useful for taking portraits. Basically, portrait doesn't only mean that you should take only this. If you are taking someone's close up also, it's a kind of portrait. So see here, it comes very good if it is having lights in the behind. Like if object is having background of full of lights, then a photo will come more good. See, when you are using low shutter, you have to use tripod. And second thing is, whenever you want to take low light photos, you have to use low shutter speed. Like it could be 1 to 100. If you are going 1 and 2 seconds, then mandatory is tripod. Tried taking a low shutter photo, but because of too many people, low shutter photo which we cannot take it, it is too much crowded. But though it is too much crowded, I tried taking a photo, but unable to keep my tripod. So now going home, and most probably I'll just go to my terrace and I'll try to take a low shutter photo, and I'll show you. So back to home. So guys, we came to the terrace. 1 second has shutter, which is very low, which means it will capture for 1 second. And I kept the lowest aperture, which is 4, and I took 3200 as ISO. Let's see how it will come. And I'm going to use this as the light ray. So couple of trial shots we are going to take now. I'll just go for timer. Why? Because in general, if you click, vibration also make impact your photo. So let's go for 2 second shot. Do. Yeah. See if you can see here. A proper semicircle has come here. Now I will try to go there and I'll try to do like light trails, and I'll ask her to stand stable. Let's see that. So if you can see, this is a beautiful photo now. So this is how you're going to do light trail effects. But as you have just seen, we took multiple shots, so in general, these kind of photos will take a lot of time. They give you joy. So if you are following our videos, do follow our next video as well. In that, we are going to tell you what kind of lenses should be used for which purpose. Do like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much.